Welcome back. I'm Blake McLain, and I'm a music producer. So today I'm going to be reacting to 5 Seconds of Summer, Teeth, Live from the Vault, as per request. I have gotten this one so much over the past couple days as a request, so I'm so excited because Easier was absolutely amazing. Like, it blew my mind and really, like, upped my expectations for 5 Seconds of Summer. So for everyone to say go watch this, I'm pretty stoked. Before I get started, please give me a subscribe down there and give me a like if you enjoy the video. I'll put my social media down in the bottom. Please give me a follow on Instagram, on Twitter. Really appreciate it. I could use all the help I can possibly get. So yeah, without further ado, let's dive right in. Cool angle. I've heard this song. I haven't seen this. Full disclosure. That's dope. Love the filter.
Some days you're the only thing I know. Only thing that's burning when the nights grow cold. Can't look away, can't look away.
Okay, so that's almost the same thing as what I said in Easier. They're doing the same technique, it's not the same music or anything. But it's the same technique. It's even, actually, it's a softer bass this time. So the bass, it's just him, the vocal and the bass. Just the vocal and the bass. And so what's happening is because of that, they don't want his vocal fighting with the bass. They want it to feel as up close to you and personal as possible. And like they're working well together. It's mixing. So the bass is super soft because his vocal has... like a really nice warm depth to it. So in the last one, in Easier, they actually had like this really grungy, like crunchy, dry bass on top of his vocal. So you either have to do like one extreme or the other when someone is singing lower like that. Otherwise, they will do this.
Beg you to stay, beg you to stay, yeah. Sometimes you're a stranger cool. In my bed. Don't know if you love me or you want me dead. Push me away, push me away.
So that's doing kind of like what Charlie Puth does in Attention, where it starts out, this is, I always talk about contrast, it starts out really nice and soft and gives you that dynamic, that lower dynamic. Then here they break into that pre-hook, like, call me in the morning too, like that, where it's just really nice and big and open. There isn't really anything going on, no drums, no nothing like that. And they do use that riser to just kind of build the anxiety like they would in a horror, you know, a horror film like a trailer. And then they just drop it. But they don't give you, like a lot of times, you know, your brain thinks it's going to go like this from, you know, continue to build. But instead they go here and then they just drop into this really nice, gritty, dirty hook. So they do, I mean, that's what I was talking about last time too, those contrasting vocals. Like, it's not a pop song if it doesn't have like one, you know, someone sings this, someone else sings this. So you have that never, ever, ever, ever let go, like in response, which is cool. So it gives you that.
You're the best thing in my life.
Nice.
Sometimes when I look at you, I see my wife. And you come into somebody I don't know. And you push me.
Huge fan of the bush. Huge fan.
Call me in the morning to apologize. Every little like everybody flies.
Okay, so they brought the drums in just to throw a layer. I like it. But they're half time. Another layer. So those layers that they're adding on are for people like me that are insanely ADD and just constantly need something pulling at their ear. So like every couple bars, it's like I said, it's that Max Martin thing. You gotta bring something new into the music or change something. That way it keeps people's attention. Almost like a post-hardcore thing, like, or a pop-punk thing, which that's what it is. Their pop-punk roots are kind of showing through there, because like that's what you want when you're at a live show and you want it to drop, and then you want those drums to come in with that get like that. Oh, I love that. That gets me. Also, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but from a production standpoint, they're behind the snare. I'm paying huge attention to the drums on this because I just can't help it. They're so awesome. On the snare, which is, you know, the there's an ah that he's using, like a whispered ah, ah, to make it feel like everything is closer to you, like it's right in front of your face, and kind of give it a little bit of that creepy feeling too. A lot of times they'll do that on vocals as well. There will be like a whisper track underneath the recorded vocal, so it'll be like some days you're the only one that knows, and you can barely hear it if you listen for it, but it just gives it that up close kind of creepy feeling. The whole thing had like a Dexter feel, and it almost reminds me of like if My Chemical Romance and like Circa Survive just got together and were like, okay, let's start a pop band and see how this works, and then just put his amazing vocals on it. Like, I'm beyond impressed yet again. Thank you all for showing me this stuff, because it has just warmed my heart. So please, if you enjoyed the video, give me a subscribe, give me a like. Also, tomorrow I'm probably going to be doing Panic of the Disco, so tune in for that, check it out, and yeah, see y'all then. Later.